It's a lot of fun to explore Missouri's complex landscape, geology, and hydrology, both on and below the ground. But there are some questions you just can't answer without a broader view. What's the age of the bedrock here? Where's the water in the stream coming from? Are there sinkholes nearby? That's where GeoSTRAT comes in.
GeoSTRAT is a fantastic web-based mapping application provided by the Missouri Department of Natural Resources and the Missouri Geological Survey to assist citizens in interpretation and understanding of our subsurface resources. Using GeoSTRAT, you can explore map-based datasets for all sorts of interesting natural and human features. Here, we'll quickly demonstrate the basics of how to use this application and highlight five datasets we think are particularly cool: geologic maps, geologic structures, dye paths, mine inventories, and well logs. Just to clarify, we're not affiliated with DNR or the survey, and this isn't an official or comprehensive tutorial. This platform has a lot of features and tools to explore, but here I'm just going to point out a few of the most basic and essential. Here on the left, you can display or hide datasets by clicking boxes that toggle layers on or off. For example, displaying geologic structures shows us that Missouri has a lot of faults, but we knew that. Some of these layers are grayed out, meaning they won't display until you zoom to an appropriate scale. So if you want to look at well log locations, make sure you zoom into a target area until the layer isn't grayed out and the data starts showing up. The other feature I'll point out is base maps, which appear behind the data. GeoSTRAT's default is this basic topography, but if you go up to this button, you can choose lots of other options like satellite imagery and even digitized topographic maps. This isn't just about aesthetics. Different base maps can be really useful for navigating and locating features on the ground. Be patient when loading layers and base maps. Some of these contain a lot of data and may not load instantly, especially depending on your internet connection. So now let's take a quick tour of a few examples to demonstrate what GeoSTRAT can do. First up is geologic maps, which show where different bedrock formations are present at or near the surface. GeoSTRAT has three layers at different mapping scales. The 1 to 500,000 map covers the entire state, while the other two aren't comprehensive but were mapped at a more detailed scale. This is a great way to learn more about Missouri's bedrock geology and give insight into what rocks you might see in a given location. Just click on a color or location to load a window telling you what the dataset has to say about it. Second, let's return to geologic structures, including faults, anticlines, synclines, and other features. Most faults in Missouri are long dormant and no meaningful threat, but it's still interesting to explore their patterns, especially since faults often affect surface topography and karst. There are also some pretty neat stories hinted at by this dataset. For example, circular fracture patterns like this show up in a linear trend line across Missouri, and geologists still debate whether these represent ancient meteor impacts and/or subsurface volcanic activity. But that's a topic for another day. Third, dye paths are a great way to appreciate Missouri's complex underground hydrology. The state's extensive karst produces lots of springs that draw water from unusual locations completely unrelated to the surface topography. These converging lines document the connections between places where dye markers were released into sinkholes or other locations, and where the dye reappeared in a spring's outflow. Looking at the dye trace layer really underlines how important it is to protect surface water quality in Missouri, because water pollution in one watershed can travel many miles underground before surfacing in a completely different watershed. As karst expert Tom Ailey has said, "In the Ozarks, what goes down must come up." An especially good example is this spring along the current river in southern Missouri. The spring itself drains into a watershed that flows south into Arkansas and eventually into the lower Mississippi River. But all three dye traces leading to the spring started on the surface in areas that otherwise drain north toward the Missouri River in central Missouri. In other words, this spring's hydrologic system bridges the region's biggest drainage divide. Now let's look at a few neat human features in GeoSTRAT. First, let's return to the well log data from earlier. This dataset shows the locations of many water wells drilled in the state. But what's really cool is that most of these retain the core logs showing what the drill went through, which is a fantastic way to learn about the sediment and rock sequences beneath a given location. Click on a given well, then on the View Drill Log link, which will pop up a scan of the original hand-drawn well log. This one goes down over 900 feet. How to interpret these handwritten logs is beyond the scope of this video, but look for a link below on how to do this. Keep in mind that the information is only as good as the person recording the log. Mistakes do happen. Second, let's look at mine inventory. This dataset marks the location of mines, quarries, and other resource extraction activities around the state, both under and above ground. Clicking on a mine symbol will load available information, potentially including depth, age, and resource extracted. For example, here in central Missouri, you can find everything from a 177-foot deep coal mine dating back to 1875, and a much more recent surface pit for refractory clay. Going down into the deep Ozarks, you can find mining for other things like surface gravel and underground copper and iron. This is a great way to learn more about the intersection between Missouri's geologic and human history. But this fantastic resource comes with a serious warning. Don't abuse it. Most of Missouri's landscape is private. Old mine entrances are dangerous. Don't use this resource to trespass, invade people's privacy, or risk yours or others' personal safety. To wrap this up, let's try to answer the questions about this location that I posed at the start. How old is the bedrock here? Well, if we turn on the 1 to 24,000 bedrock map and click, we find that it's mostly Mississippian age limestone. Where does the water in this spring come from? Well, if we look for dye traces, we find one source fully 3 miles away in a different drainage basin. Keep in mind that this is just one source, not the only source, but it's pretty cool nonetheless. And are there sinkholes nearby? Well, let's toggle the sinkhole layer and, yep, I'd say there are sinkholes nearby. In fact, this area has more craters than a World War I battlefield.
Now that you're familiar with GeoSTRAT, have fun using it to explore Missouri's fascinating geologic resources. It's fitting that a state with so many sinkholes would develop such an effective time sink.